Everyone, I'm standing here with.
Hi, everyone. This is Stefano Alberico speaking, and so we are talking here about our crypto solution. And I understand you, as the audience, are very technical, so I can probably go a little bit more in details. And crypto basically is a solution that provides end-to-end encryption. So we have a software app that runs on Android, and then. We also decided to build an external hardware device because, as you know very well, software is, especially Android and phones are actually weak points and can be hacked. And you need a safe place where you to store your encryption keys. Mm. So we decided to actually build an external hardware. And this external hardware will perform all the encryption and will actually generate and hold the encryption keys. So I can show you actually, which is pretty cool. This is really the first prototype, which is a simple ARM CPU where we run a Linux and all the software, encryption software, runs in here. Now, this device can be connected to a mobile phone where we have our own application. And through this, we can actually talk, end-to-end between two users. Now, our next step has been in evolution, say, we can actually not trust any hardware manufacturer, so we decided to build our own encryption chip, and actually we build smaller, and we build an FPGA which contain all the encryption algorithm. And this FPGA is pretty cool because, of course, you can imagine you have all the encryption running there, plus you have a true random number generator, and this is extremely safe, and the keys are generated and holding in here. So since this is end-to-end, that means both ends needs to have the same device.
Right.
So they can then communicate, meaning sending files, messages, photos, making calls,
right,
and between two persons. Now I tell you another couple of use cases. Now, since we have a very strong encryption solution here, then we decided to extend it and add a crypto wallet.
Right.
So this device will hold also your cryptocurrency.
So this is a wallet.
It becomes also a wallet.
Right,
so
right.
We have also the software application, and this is optional if you are extremely, let's say, paranoid.
Right, right.
So you can add this, and it's also a wallet, and then you can make payment, through other people, end to end, basically.
Right. Something like, you could say, like a Nano S Ledger or a Trezor, right?
Well, basically, Nano and Ledger are actually just wallet.
Right,
this
right.
is similar for that functionality to them.
Right, and more.
And more, let's say, if you want to go very specific, they use standard third-party ST microchip electronic, the chip.
Yep.
We have an FPGA.
Right, you've developed your own chip.
Yeah,
right.
And we want to be very open on the FPGA, so in principle we can have third-party peer review.
We can
reveal all our
open
architecture
source.
And software.
Yep.
Open source, so you can make sure that there are no backdoors.
Right, right.
Then another interesting use case is that you can have your own USB memory stick.
Right.
And let's say you operate as an airtight laptop.
Like that small thing right there.
Let's say you operate with an airtight laptop.
Mm-hmm.
So you are used to a laptop with never touch internet.
Mm-hmm.
You use those kind of a USB memory stick to save your file. And those little stick, you send it across to your friends really by snail mail, or give it by hand. This is the typical way for some people to work.
Yeah.
What we give you is you take your USB memory stick, you plug it here.
Mm-hmm.
The device will encrypt all the file directly in the hardware. They will go to your other colleague, which will have the same device plugged with a USB memory stick.
Right.
File will be decrypted here and copied directly to USB. So what you have is end-to-end USB to USB maximum security.
Wow.
It never touched any operating system. There is no operating system here. So it's the safest security you can get. And this holds the encryption and the decryption keys for
that. Right. So this holds the encryption.
Yeah.
And you mentioned something about a communication application. So
yes.
I could download that from your site in the future.
Yeah.
Which is
crypto. It will be the app. Yeah. With this crypto app, which we call Shield, while the crypto device we call Black.
Right.
So eventually, you will be available. Will be possible for you to download directly from our site.
Right.
It's gonna be in any app stores for some time. So it's gonna be directly on our website, and we're gonna have actually a free trial in the February, March. If you go on our homepage, you can actually sign in and get a free license. So the first 500 people will get free license. So if you join quickly, you can get it. And then the last bits I want to mention also, if you see that card which is
right,
here,
right.
So this is our way of identify users.
Mm-hmm.
So typically when you use a mobile application,
you are identified through your mobile phone number, which is a unique number in the world with the area code.
Right.
So what we do is, like, we don't want to know your name, we don't want to know your phone number, we don't collect any of your data.
Right.
We give you a serial number, which is, you know, printing this QR code. We give you a pseudonym.
Right.
So every user has his own card, which also helps as a multiple factor authenticator. With our app, you can scan the card, and then the system identify yourself.
That's
and you are anonymous serial number.
Right. You just become anonymous, a serial,
through this.
That's
so
crazy.
We don't know, and no one knows your phone number, and no one knows your data around that. Then the last bits, it's about the ICO. So we are about to launch an ICO.
Yeah.
Because we actually want to decentralize part of the services. For example, the authentication of the user could be decentralized in a blockchain. But we also want to build an open network where people can become participate, becoming like nodes.
Mm-hmm.
So with our token, which now here is just a piece of chocolate, you can actually pay with the token, so it's a utility token. So you can pay the service with the token, and if you are a node, you can get paid with the same token. So that will create a little economy.
Yeah. Kind of like ours, like the Rivets token, but a utility token,
yes,
right?
Yes, exactly. That's a similar similar approach to ours.
Yeah, great.
And we are based in Estonia. And
So based in Estonia.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Although I'm Italian, but as you can hear from my accent, thick accent.
Yeah, and we were talking about a potential partnership, but we don't exactly know how.
So it would be very interesting actually to have a talk with your CEO, CTO, have a talk and really understand how we can cooperate. We definitely love technology. And I'm sure that we love also this kind of solutions.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Thank you for explaining. Bye-bye.